You want to see something cool?
Yeah, I want to see something cool.
Lakeman's going to park in my space again today.
Tonight's film is a dramatization of Marie Rothenberg's account of events surrounding the burning and survival of her son, David.
Sweetheart, time to get up.
Guess what?
What?
My spider stopped raining out.
Good. More galoshes.
David, what are all these dirty clothes doing all over the floor?
I forgot.
You forgot. You know where they go. I can't find David. Well, where did David go? Well, I guess I just better make the bed.
No.
So, what are you wearing today, huh?
About my elephant t-shirt and some jeans.
Okay, but hurry up because you're running late.
Faster than a speeding bullet, stronger than a charging
my house, Superman! I'm leaving a note for John. Did Fonzie enjoy his breakfast? I told you, I'm your mother. I know everything. You can't hide anything from me. No, no, I know it all, and don't you forget it! Come on, we're late. The right arm, the left arm.
today.
Uh-huh. Before we go to the station.
I don't want to be a policeman.
What's the matter? John's a good guy.
Are you going to marry him?
Maybe. What do you think?
Am I going to live with you?
Of course. Why would you even ask me such a question? David?
Daddy!
Hey, there's my big boy.
Oh, I...
Come on, fellas, we're late.
Oh, Marie, why don't you let him have a little fun once in a while?
Charles, the bell's rung.
I have to talk to you, Marie.
Can it wait? I'm running late.
No, it can't wait. I want David this weekend.
John is taking him. Any other weekend, you know that, but John made plans.
He's my son, Marie, not John's. He belongs to me.
Yeah, I belong to you.
Yeah. Hey.
I don't want to discuss this with you now.
Then when?
Tonight, after 8, after John leaves. I don't want anything getting in the way of this relationship.
Come
you
on,
understand?
Davey, come on, let's go. I don't want you to be late for school, boy.
Marie.
Yeah, like Superman, huh?
What happened to you?
I missed the train.
Want to have lunch?
Maybe tomorrow.
John?
Hi, it's me.
Did that wake you up?
I know, I wish we were back on day schedule.
Nothing?
Just wanted to make sure you were coming over later. I love you.
Here, Marie. Who takes care of my son?
I do. Good care. I have to work. Someone has to bring money in.
Oh. You're always throwing that up in my face, aren't you, Marie?
Don't start with me, Charles. We're not married anymore. You're not a part of my life now, except as David's father.
You and John are trying to take David away from me, aren't you?
What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
You see, David, whenever you want.
Don't you want to tease me anymore, Daddy? Don't you want to play?
Mommy won't let me.
Why?
Because it's time for dinner. Wash up, please, David.
But, Mommy, Dad...
No buts. Wash up now, okay?
You don't talk to him like that.
Mommy won't let me? What are you doing?
I'm not the one, Marie.
Yes, you are. You're the one. And for what? For what? To get David for the weekend? But you tell me you don't get what you want? You act like a baby. You're worse than David. What if John and I get married and move away? Then what are you going to do?
What do you mean?
Nothing.
You and John are moving away from here, taking David away?
No, forget it. I shouldn't have said anything. I promised John.
John, everything for John. What about me?
You're not my concern anymore, are you?
Your mommy doesn't want me here anymore. John? John, wait.
Charlie, what are you doing here?
I need your help. I'm losing David.
You're not losing anything. David worships you.
Yeah, but not anymore. Marie won't let him see me now. She's turning him against
me. Come on, Charlie, don't waste my time. Hassled Marie all afternoon.
But it's true. I want him for the weekend. Marie says no.
Because I made plans over a month ago.
But
look, Charlie, if you want David for the weekend, take him. We'll go some other time if it's that important to you. But don't put them through this anymore.
Marie called you, didn't she?
That's not the point.
But you don't know my side. She's always throwing you up to
me. Don't put me in the middle anymore, Charlie. It's Between you and Marie, work it out.
I love my son. David means everything to me.
Then act like it. Grow up. Act like a father.
I'm a good father. Look. Look. Look, I got this beeper, so now he can call me whenever he wants. I got a special number just for him, so now when he calls me, like, I can call him right back.
Charlie. It's late. Shut the door and go home.
You talk to her. Use your influence. Please.
Listen to you. You don't let her turn my son against me.
Please.
You still up?
Took me a long time to get him to sleep. Charles gets him all wound up.
He's not the only one.
He came by the station tonight.
What did he want?
Pastrami on rye. What do you mean, what did he want? He wants Davey for the weekend.
I told him never to bother you at
he
work.
He bothers me. Bothers me a lot.
What did you say?
Told him okay. And then I gave the hockey tickets to my partner. He's taking his son to the playoffs.
You didn't have to do that. I would have told him no.
Oh, sure, sure. And then he would have told Davey. Davey would have cried all weekend. You would have went crazy, started arguing with good old Charles. And I would have been left with the fallout from all of you.
You know, for Flatfoot, you're not as dumb as you look. You want a sandwich?
Like old times now.
Thanks for seeing me, Marie. I have news. I don't work at Luchow's anymore.
You're not in trouble, are you?
No, no. It's good news this time. This time I quit. I got a new job. It's better, more pay. J&O's car service. It's right around the corner from you and Davey.
Around the corner? You be wanting more time with David?
Less. That's why I wanted to have lunch with you to talk about my schedule. But I think you'll be pleased. I think we can finally work something out.
Really? That would be great. I just want what's best for all of us, Charles.
That's all I want, Marie. Especially for my son.
You know, you always made me feel as though I had nothing to do with David. It was just the two of you.
That's not me, Marie. That's Davy.
Look, I gotta get back to work. What did you figure out?
Well, since... Since I won't have as much time with Davy now because of the new job, you know, I'll be working nights and weekends. Well, I want to break it to him myself.
What do you want to break to him? You're around the corner, aren't you?
You remember when Davy thought that I didn't love him anymore because I couldn't come to see him, so this time I want to... Well, I have to break it to him myself. This time he has to hear it from me. I don't ever want him to be without a father the way I was. It's a terrible feeling.
What do you want from me?
A week with David alone.
A week? I thought you wanted him for the weekend.
Well, I made reservations in the Catskills for the weekend so we can go back to that game farm. But I got 6 days off before my new job starts. And I want David to stay over at my place with me. Just him and me.
No, I don't know.
Come on, Marie. It's what... Just a few blocks from your house. Come on.
What about school?
What, he won't miss anything. I'll have him at school on time every day. What do you say, Marie? Come on, be a pal. Let me have next week with him. It'll give you and John time alone together.
All right, take him for a week.
Great. Thanks.
I don't want to hear any more about more time. A week. That's it.
Word of honor.
Okay, now, let's see. Is that everything?
I want my elephant t-shirt.
All right. What about Bear? Don't you want to take Bear?
Uh-uh.
I thought you loved Bear.
I got my daddy.
Oh, all right.
Hey, anybody here?
Hey, look at this, will you, huh? Something, huh? Yeah, we can throw this old shopping bag away.
I feel like I forgot something. Oh, I know. Shoes. He'll need another pair.
What he's wearing is fine. Don't worry, Marie. I'll take care of him.
Well, what if the weather changes?
I said what he's wearing is fine.
I'll tell you what. I'll walk you guys part way. I think we have an early train.
Okay, let's go. Come on, we're out of here.
Be a good boy now, and you listen to Daddy. David, you know if you want to talk to Mommy, if you want to come home.
Not now, Mommy. Come on.
Come on, we better go, Marie. We'll be fine, won't we, Davy? Yeah, come on, in we go. Hey.
Put your seatbelt on.
Stopped at the holding tank, these 8th Avenue hookers, they screamed. You listening?
Yeah, they haven't heard. What time is it?
About 10 minutes later than last time. What's with you?
I just want to talk with David.
Well, you call him when we get home. Knowing Davy, they're probably at Mama Donato's right now having a big bowl of spaghetti.
Probably. It's the only thing David will eat.
Hey, watch your back.
Excuse me. Hasn't even been one full day yet.
I know. I had this funny feeling all day something is wrong.
What up, Mom? It's crazy.
I don't know. I can't explain it.
Relax, please.
Yeah, yeah. I'm really, really gonna have so much fun. Whoa, California, here we come.
tomorrow, honey, just like I promised, huh? You know, has Daddy ever broken a promise to you?
Nope.
And you know what? The airplane ride's gonna be almost as much fun as Disneyland, huh?
Yeah.
Want some more pizza? Yeah. But you gotta remember, honey, that this is our special secret. You can't tell anybody.
Not even Mommy?
No. No, not even Mommy.
Why?
Because this trip belongs to you and me. And you know, Mommy get very angry if she found out we're going to go someplace without her. And you know what happens to Mommy when she gets very angry, right? Oh, good boy, Davey. Oh, I love you.
Aren't you going to answer the phone?
No, I'm not going to talk to anybody. Just you and me, Davey, our special secret. From now on, hmm?
Just you and me.
No answer?
No, but it's getting late.
Yeah, you probably went out for some ice cream. Come on, you can call him tomorrow morning. Before they leave.
Honey.
Let's go find a motel room first. We can wash up, we can have some dinner, then we'll hit Disneyland first thing tomorrow morning. Oh, wow, they got miniature golf. All right, you guard the car. I'll go get us a room, all right? You stay right here where I can keep an eye on you.
Okay.
Hi. I, I'd like a room.
Single?
No, it's a double. For me and my son. I brought him here to see Disneyland. It's always been his dream.
Name, please?
My name is David. David Love.
You're in 119. You, I haven't been able to reach Charles.
Nope, because I don't think anything's wrong.
What if he's kidnapped David?
Oh, come on, Marie. Charlie's taken David a million times. Nothing's ever happened.
Well, what if this time is different? What if this time he's taken David away?
Hey, honey, look at this. Beautiful, isn't it?
I didn't think it. I'm sure it's too expensive.
Sorry.
It's okay. Next time.
You know what I really think? Besides the fact your imagination's running wild, I think you're jealous.
Of what?
Charlie and Davey.
That's ridiculous.
Is it? I've watched you. Kills you that they're so close.
What kills me is you're not taking this seriously.
Marie, you have nothing to go on but a feeling.
And Charles, I know him. I don't trust him.
Why'd you let Davey go?
I don't know.
Not, Tiger. It's closed because of the rain.
But, Dad, you said we could go.
Yeah, I know, but we can't. So, come on, put on your coat. Let's go back to the motel and we'll watch some TV. Oh, come on. Baby, what are you doing?
I want to go back to the motel.
We're going to go. We're going to go back to the motel now.
No, I
want
to go to Disneyland.
All right, put your coat on. Let's go back.
No.
Oh, Davey.
No.
Oh, stop.
No, I want to go to Disneyland.
Now. Come on.
No, get away from me. No!
Come on!
No. Why are we here? This is not a hotel.
Yeah, but this place is better. This place has got an arcade by the pool.
Still like the other place better.
Okay. Okay. I got an even better surprise, huh? Run for it! Come on! Look at this! Huh? A water bed! Okay, so you like it better now?
Yeah!
Yeah!
I'm gonna get you next time!
David? David? I gotta get out of here. Will you be all right? Okay, you wait right here, won't you, till I get back?
Have some more quarters to hold me over?
Sure. Here you go. Okay.
Yes, John Cirillo, please. Marie Rothenberg calling.
One moment. Hi, hon. I just get in. What's that?
There's still no answer at Charles's place. I called school, and David never showed up today. He wasn't there on Friday. What do you think?
Try him again.
I just did.
Look, John, I've been trying all day. There's got to be something you can do, please.
All right, all right. Take it easy. I'll look into it. Where were they supposed to be this weekend?
In the Catskills. Charles rented a cabin to take David to the game farm they went to last year. John? John, are you there?
I'm sorry, Marie. I should have asked you sooner.
You're sorry about what?
Well, I've been up in that area. That's a summertime operation. It's closed at this time of the year.
Oh, my God. Where are they?
Can't.
It's pouring.
There's nothing to do here.
I want to go to Disneyland. You promised.
You want to hit the arcade again?
I'm sick of the arcade.
Okay. Oh, I got a great idea. Let's go to a movie, huh?
What movie do you want to see?
Come on. We'll go to...
I'm talking to Mommy now.
No.
Mommy, I want to go home.
Huh? Don't you want to stay here with Dad? Oh, I'm sorry, Davey. I'm sorry I was mean to you, but we belong together. Huh? As father and son belong together.
This is ridiculous. How much longer?
I'm sorry, ma'am. We have to wait for papers from
the town. Look, I already told you. I called Lou Charles and got a warrant out for his arrest. What more do you want?
Who's got the keys? Jim, you come with me. Please move back.
Stay back.
The rest of you stay put. Police officers, we're coming in.
Here's something. Left a note. Thanks for everything. I will not be returning. Charles Rothenberg.
We'll put out an APB on both of them right away. Mrs. Rothenberg, have you got some recent photos? That's good. Where can I reach you tomorrow?
Home. I won't be going to work.
Would you normally go in?
Yes.
I really think it's better if you do go in. Now, please, Mrs. Rothenberg, as long as he knows your schedule, I'd advise you not to change it.
I just want my baby back. Please. Fine. No cream, one sugar, right? Marie Rothenberg. Hello? Are you? What have you done with David?
He's here with me.
Let me talk to him.
You can't.
Why not?
He's sleeping.
What do you mean he's sleeping? Why is he still asleep?
It's only 7 o'clock.
It's 10 o'clock in the morning here.
Where are you?
Let me talk to David right now.
He can't talk now.
Wake him up!
I want to talk to him right now.
Are you in California? Answer me, Charles!
He's my son, Marie. I have rights.
You don't have the right to take David out of New York State without my permission. That was our agreement. Now bring him back. Now!
I can't stand listening to your mouth anymore.
Screaming at me. No more, Marie.
I swear to you, Charles, when I get David back, you will never, ever see him again. Do you understand? Never!
That's it, Marie. I'm finished. I promise you'll never find David now.
Charles, no!
I warned you. Don't threaten me like that. Don't ever threaten me about David!
I'm sorry, Charles, please. Forgive me. I didn't know, Charles. You scared me. You took David away and you scared me. Please.
I thought about it a long time last night. I was going to give you another chance, but I can't now.
Goodbye, Marie.
Please, Charles, no! Where are you? Charles! Charles, where are you?
Time to sleep.
But I'm not tired.
Come on, honey, hop in.
What's that for?
That's a pill. So you'll sleep better. So you'll feel rested when we go to Disneyland. Come on. Come on, drink it with this. Good boy. And if you fall out of bed, then you won't hurt yourself. Good boy. I got you first. Okay, come on. Come on. Oh, you want a Bronco, huh? How many rides you want to go on tomorrow, huh?
About 25.
25? You can go on 26 if you go to sleep quick. Get the rest. Yeah. Oh, that's my boy. No more hurts, huh? No more people pulling at you. No more people fighting over you. There's no more threats.
Yes.
Mrs. Rothenberg? Mrs. Marie Rothenberg?
Yes.
Mrs. Rothenberg, I have a telegram for you. May I read it?
Go ahead.
Dear Marie, by the time you read this, I will have terminated my existence. You have caused me enough harm. I have been through enough in my life.
It's from Charles Rothenberg, isn't it? What does he say about David? What does he say about my son?
Also be informed that your son has been in an accident and has been taken to the burn center at the University of California Irvine Medical Center.
What are you talking about? What kind of accident?
That's all I have. I'm very sorry, Mrs. Rothenberg.
Yeah, public information. Can I help you?
I'm calling from New York. I'd like to speak to whoever is in charge, please.
Well, that would be me, ma'am. I'm Officer Terry Branham.
I'm searching for my child. He may have been in an accident. Do you have a little boy there? Sweetheart, we're going to move your arm just a little bit, okay? Good boy. Good boy. You work right along with us, sweet thing. You're going to be all right.
Let's try morphine, 3 milligrams. Huh?
Chambers.
All right, what's his name? Let me ask him. There's a woman on the line from New York who thinks this might be her son. Okay, honey. I want you to nod if you can hear me. Good boy. Is your name David? He's nodding yes. His name is David.
Oh, my God. I'll be on the next plane out.
They're on 24-hour guard.
That's the standard procedure in a case like this, ma'am.
A case like this.
Honey, they think Charlie set the fire.
Charles?
Mrs. Rothenberg, I think you should be prepared. David was very badly burned. He's unrecognizable.
If that's David.
Honey, you better take off your coat. The doctors say he's critical. His body is completely open.
That's why we gotta scrub up and put on these robes. And you gotta wash your hands.
One other thing, whoever did this to him, his father or somebody else, is still out there.
Any leads yet?
Just a woman at the motel.
What if it is Charles?
Don't you worry. We're gonna have a 24-hour guard on this room until he's brought in.
I wanna see the child. Not my son.
What if it is Murray?
No, it's not my David.
Murray. David? It's John. I'm here with your mommy. Both right here beside you, pal. But bear, see?
Maybe you better take her out.
Yeah. No. No, I'm gonna be with him. I want David to know I'm here.
He's barely conscious, Mrs. Rothenberg.
I don't care. David will know. My son will know. David, Mom is here, sweetheart. I'm here. I'm here. I love you.
Murray, we better go.
No.
Yeah.
Come with me. No.
It's the bandages. Look, they know what they're doing. Marie. Marie.
Some coffee. Yeah, come on, come on, come on. I'll get you some coffee. There's some things I wanted to ask you anyway without you around.
You mean about Charlie?
Yeah. Everybody's looking for him. We're having the biggest manhunt we ever had around here. Can you give us any kind of a lead?
He's weak. In his mind, he thinks everyone's out to get him.
Do you have any friends?
Not that I know of. Maybe some prison buddies.
He's an ex-con?
Oh, yeah. Old Charlie's got quite a record. Even the FBI was after
him. Did she know about that?
Not until after they were married. They were together a few years. She found out he was stealing. She threw him out.
How's your financial situation?
Not good.
Well, we started a fund at the department for David. We're jammed with calls.
Mrs. Rothenberg, I'm Dr. Akauer.
David, how is he? Can I see him?
Well, I think you'd be better off getting some sleep.
I'm staying here.
Listen to the doctor, Marie. There's nothing we can do for Davy now.
I'm not leaving.
Your son has third-degree burns over 90% of his body. He's in shock. He's lost a lot of fluid. At this rate, his kidneys could fail. David is an open wound. He's a target for every infection, every complication. The next 48 hours are critical.
What does that mean?
Your son... Mrs. Rothenberg, David will probably die.
Dr. Caro, surgery, please. Dr. Caro.
Honey. Honey, come to bed.
Charles is out there. Somewhere.
Listen to you when you had a feeling something was wrong.
What do you want me to say?
I don't know. Maybe it's better if...
If what? If David dies?
If he does make it, what kind of life is he going to have? It isn't fair to him. All the scarring, the disfiguring.
I don't want to hear any more of this.
We have to talk about it, Marie. We have to think about what kind of future David's going to have.
I don't care about that. David's life is now, tonight.
If they can pull him through. You have to face reality, Marie.
No.
You know what lies ahead for David if he lives. You know he'll never have a normal life.
I don't want to hear any more of this.
His mother. Is this what you want for him?
I have the strength. Mary, Mother of God, forgive me for what I've done. Forgive me because I want my baby to die. Help me.
Operator, this is Commander Miller from the Buena Park Fire Department. I'm calling to inquire about the little boy that was brought in. Yeah, the one from the fire. No, I can't hold on. I just want to find out how David is. Well, can you tell me? I already said I'm from the fire department. Damn you!
Hello? Hello?
Calls back. Keep him talking as long as he can. Don't let him talk to anybody else. I don't want him to know how or where David is.
Hi.
How is he?
He's about the same. I stayed with him most of the night. It's time for the hydro. You know what they're going to be doing to him now in the baths? He's raw, and they'll be scraping more of him away.
I don't know what to say, Mary.
Why haven't they found Charles? What's taking them so long? Every cop in the country is out looking for him, and they can't find him.
They will. It takes time.
David doesn't have time. My son is in there fighting for his life. And there's not a damn thing I can do to help him. So little, he's so helpless. I want to hold him so bad to tell him it's going to be all right, and I can't. There's no place to touch him. His body's burned away. His face is gone. My baby's gone. I want my baby.
Wayne Park Police. No, I'm sorry. I can't give any information about David on the telephone. Clark, any news on David's condition?
There's no change at this time.
No news is no news.
Officer Branham, is there an update on David?
Not at this time.
Any news on the whereabouts of David's father?
Not at this time.
Is that when we see David tonight?
I understand how you feel, Charlie.
Is David in a lot of pain? Is he in a lot of pain?
We know you love your son. We all know you've been through a lot. Don't you think you ought to come in? Give yourself a break, buddy. Come in for David.
What is it, David? Slow down, he needs a rest. Maybe he needs more pain medication. Why don't you ask him if he's in pain? I'm telling you to talk to him. Ask him. David will respond.
Mrs. Rothenberg, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
No. No, you can't treat my son this way.
Dr. Akar, please. Sue Martinez calling about the burn boy in room 3B.
No, he's not the burn boy in 3B.
Thank you. I'll hold.
It's David. David Rothenberg.
I see. Well, just tell him that I called.
He's a little boy. He's frightened. He can't speak. He can't see. And he can't feel anything but pain until my son can speak for himself again, until David can see again. I am his voice. I am his eyes.
Marie, listen, I just got a call from downstairs. A couple of people here to see you.
What people? I don't want to see anyone.
The man was a burn patient. They want to help you.
You have your nerve. David's not your kid. He's mine. You're not going through this. I am. I don't want to see anybody, especially anybody to burn.
Mrs. Rothenberg, I'm Judy Curtis. Believe me, I know what you're going through. My husband was in a terrible accident, an explosion. We didn't think he'd make it through.
I was burned over 50% of my body, including my face.
No, you haven't been burned. I don't believe you've been burned. You haven't been burned.
That's why we wanted to meet you. We wanted you to see.
Surely there's been a major break in a case that police have been waiting and waiting for. A New York man accused of setting his son on fire in a Buena Park motel room appeared relieved today after officers arrested him at a San Francisco YMCA. Hurry. The capture of Charles Rothenberg ends one of the most extensive manhunts in Southern California history. An anticipated full confession, however, adds a bizarre note to this most heinous of crimes. If the boy does survive, we have learned from the district attorney's office the maximum sentence that Rothenberg could receive.
Telephone, please, Dr. Klein. Dr. Carroll, surgeon.
I have to go back tomorrow.
Can you get an extended leave?
Tried.
I need you to stay with me.
Honey, I've been gone 3 weeks already, and I'll be here for the sentence.
You don't have to go right back. You just can't deal with all this. You can't even look at David.
Can't stand seeing him like this. What do you see when you look at him?
Just David.
He's not just Davey anymore. I see a different little boy.
You're looking in the wrong place.
I wish I could change the way I feel.
So do I. John says goodbye. He tried to see you before he left, but you were sleeping. So, I guess it is really just the two of us now. He loves you, David.
It's routine with burn patients. The cartilage is brittle. It falls away.
What else can I expect, Dr. Akauer? But other parts of my son are going to routinely fall away.
Yeah, Marie.
He doesn't have very much left. It's important to me. His ears, like everything else about him, are important to me.
I know that.
And I don't want to be surprised like that again.
Now, wait a minute.
If you even have the slightest idea that something could happen, I want to know about it before it happens. Or so help me, I'll pull my son out of here.
All right. Dr. Seidelman? There's a strong possibility we may have to amputate David's fingers. because they're dead, and if we don't remove them, it will increase the risk of infection. But we're planning to continue the grafts in a day or so.
He has no skin.
He still has a small patch of skin left under his arm.
I want to know how you do that. I want to know everything. I want to know every step of the way.
You never committed the burglary or did any damage to Luchow's?
No, I never did, Luchow's. I haven't been in trouble, you know, since almost 5 years. People will tell you how good I was when I took care of my son.
Did you have it in mind at that time to leave David there to sleep by himself?
No, I was there with him.
But just to leave him there for a nap or a little sleep?
No, David never leaves. He never leaves me.
He left you the night you set the fire.
I left him.
I think your intention was to hurt David in order to get back at your wife.
No, you're wrong. I had every intention of killing myself.
Okay, then why didn't you?
Because I also have a conscience, too. It bothers me. I'm not an animal, you know? I'm just,
Well?
It was confusing to me, you know?
I don't think you wanted to do yourself in as much as you wanted to do David in. Is that right?
At the beginning, I wanted to do us both. In fact, I wanted David and myself to go in such a way that Marie would never have known about it. Just no identity at all. I wanted to kill us both.
Yeah, but you chickened out. What's not quite clear to me is what made you chicken out and why you didn't take David out of the room with you.
Where?
At the motel when you set the fire. Did you use matches?
Just one match.
When did you chicken out? When you threw the match?
I'm telling you, I just can't get into it all. It built up. I didn't want to do it, but I did.
I understand, Charlie.
Yeah, well, I don't think you do understand. You see, that's just it. You don't.
No.
But why, David? What did the kid do that made you want to hurt him?
I just couldn't take it. You don't... No. Marie, I'm not saying she's a bad person, and you don't know her. Her mouth, it... You don't know her.
No, I don't.
All right, so don't, you know... I'm not putting her down. It just... She's always resented me because I've been in trouble. And she took it out on me. I was trying to save a relationship between... You know, some communication between his mother and myself. I tried for almost 3 years. The things that she has said and have done to me in those last 3 years have not exactly been very nice. You know, I am a very patient person. I fought every day, every minute to keep my relationship with my kid. It was always her. And I found out that she was the devil, and it took me a long time to figure that out. Can you do me a favor and just keep me posted on how David's doing, you know? If there's an improvement or whatever. I'd like to know.
Take it easy, Marie.
What? Nothing to worry about.
What is it?
Come on.
See for yourself.
No tubes.
We couldn't wait for you to get here.
Hi, Mommy.
He was saving his first words for you.
Can I have some ice cream?
Soon, honey. Is that what you've been thinking about all this time?
Where's Daddy? I'm not sure, sweetheart. Well, I want to know. When's he gonna come here?
Well, Daddy's been working very hard and he's been sick.
Is he in jail?
Why do you ask?
Well, because John's been here. And he works. Come to see me. And he works. Why hasn't Daddy come here?
David.
Did he set that fire?
Yes.
Dr. Alcoa says it's to clear off my feet so as I can walk again. Anybody put shoes on me?
David, if anybody knew your daddy was gonna hurt you like this, we wouldn't have let him.
My daddy did this to me.
Yes.
Why did my daddy hurt me?
Oh, David.
Anything else you want to play with today? Who's that?
It's a bad man.
Well, tell me about this bad man.
He hurt me.
Can you give him a name? It's okay, Davy. Okay, you tell me.
It's my daddy.
And he really hurt you. I bet you're a little mad at your daddy for doing that, aren't you?
I don't know.
Well, I'd be pretty mad if somebody hurt me. I just want to hurt him back. How do you feel about that? Come on, show me. That's okay. It's okay to feel like that. It's okay, Davy. It's all right, Davy.
Okay.
better.
This is hard. I don't think I can make it.
Listen, you're doing just great.
Is this one of those difficult days you warned me about?
Yeah, it's difficult. Boy, it's so good.
You practically destroyed that doll.
The quicker David can get his anger out, the quicker he can deal with it. Let it go.
Have you heard from Big John lately?
Yeah. He's flying out for the sentencing. I feel bad. He's used up all of his vacation time.
No, I'm sure he doesn't stay up nights worrying about it.
Terry, mm-hmm. How long can they put Charles away for?
I don't know. Not long enough.
Will Charles be in the courtroom?
Yep.
I guess I'll have to face him then. I slept with him all those years. I had his son.
Come on, Marie.
Now I don't know how to look at him.
Oh, looking good, David.
What does?
You do. Have Bob make a face mask.
What do I look like? I want to know.
Okay, David. Maybe it's time.
No, it's too soon right now.
Not if he's asking.
I can't.
You got a compact?
Please, Mommy. I want to see.
Remember, David, whatever you look like now will change very soon, and you'll keep changing until you're well again.
Monster.
No, sweetheart, no. You're still Mommy's beautiful baby boy.
No, I look like a monster. I hate this.
David, remember I told you I was in a fire, too, just like you? Well, look at me. Do I look like a monster? Well, neither will you.
You look like me.
A new you. You're still you inside, aren't you? So what you look like on the outside doesn't really matter, does it? Who you are in here. That's what people really see.
Well, I wouldn't look at somebody's heads.
No. No, you wouldn't. So you help them. And you pretend they don't see them stare. Someday, they won't. You know why? Because people see what you want them to see. And someday soon, when you look in a mirror, all you'll see is your goodness and beauty. It's all inside you right now. Someday you'll see that too.
Yeah.
Okay.
do people stare? Don't they understand there's a little boy underneath all that?
All they see is a little boy who's scarred and disfigured. But when he's old enough, he'll be able to have corrective surgery.
What about now? What about all the years in between? I want people to see him for what he is now. Bright, sensitive little boy. I don't want to see him hurt anymore.
Marie, just be grateful that he's alive and that he's going to make it.
No, it's not enough. I want David to feel normal again. I won't hide him.
I don't think you understand how hard this is going to be on both of you.
I don't care.
Well, you will. Every day I see burn patients walk outside these doors with such courage. And then I watch the pain in their eyes when people turn away.
That can't happen. I can't let that happen to David.
I don't know.
Keep your eyes on where you want to go. You're going to think your balance will feel different.
Okay, here we go.
Ow!
David, come on now, do your exercises.
No, it hurts.
I know it hurts, pal. But the only way you're going to know you're getting better is when it hurts like that.
Come on, David, please.
I hate this.
I know you hate this, but you've got to do it. Please, one last time. Come on. Mommy?
Attaboy.
Good boy, David. See, now that wasn't so bad, right? Now, again.
Very good, David.
That was great.
Thanks.
You know, there was a little girl who was just brought in. She's pretty sick.
Burned, like me.
Mm-hmm. And she's not as lucky as you. She can't see.
Did her daddy burn her too?
No. No, sweetheart.
Can I see her?
Mm-hmm. I was hoping you'd say that.
Hi, Carol. How you doing today?
And David's mom. We'd like to visit with you. You feel up to it?
We brought you a present.
What is it?
A big clown. And when you get out of here, you can even dance with him. But you gotta do everything they say. Even the exercises.
I'm scared. I don't want to be all ugly and scarred. Are you?
But Dagger gives me grass.
But what do you look like?
Look like David, I guess. Cause that's who I am.
Roses are red, clouds are beautiful. Gentlemen. Put your break over here.
Thanks. My treat.
Thanks, Dick.
See you later.
Okay. No. I want to do it.
David, honey. Mommy has to help you.
Thank you.
I would just like the court to take into consideration the agony caused to my son David by his father. David's life will be changed drastically. He will never be a normal child again. David will suffer scars for the rest of his life, both mental and physical. He will not have full use of his hands. David fears every night before he goes to bed that his father will come and try to kill him again. The doctors and the nurses at the hospital have to constantly assure David that his father will never be able to come near him again, to do this to him again, ever. I feel Charles should get the maximum sentence without parole, because David deserves peace in his life.
Before I pass sentence, Mr. Rothenberg, is there anything you'd like to say?
Sit down, sir.
Thank you, Bill.
This is going to be hard for me. I would like to say something briefly to Marie and John. I know what I'm going through and will continue to go through in my life. I know what you two guys are going to be going through and what you're going to have to be going through for the rest of your lives. I'd like to now ask your forgiveness, Marie and John, as I now forgive you both. Yeah. I'd like you to take care of my beloved son, David.
Charles Rothenberg, please rise before the court. I feel it necessary to say that in all the time I've sat on this bench, I have never seen so hideous a crime, nor so innocent a victim. If it were up to me, I would sentence you for life and throw away the key. But I can't. Because you plead guilty, not even by reason of insanity, the maximum sentence I can give you is 13 years. The only consolation I have is that you will live with this for the rest of your life. That's the most horrible sentence of all. The knowledge of what you have done to your son. This court is in recess. Thank you.
goodbye to you. Say goodbye to David.
I want to walk out.
Okay, all right, honey. Okay, good. Let me drive partway, all right? Mm-hmm. All right, here we go.
My hat.
Hat. For a boy.
David, how does it feel to be going home after all you've been through?
I'm a boy. That's wonderful enough for me.